Hi, my name is Trevor Dowd, Applications Engineer with Texas Instruments DLP. This video will walk through the batch files, peripherals, and firmware panels for the DLP LightCrafter 6500 and 9000 evaluation modules. The DLP C900 firmware has the option to create, store, and execute batch files within the firmware. These batch files contain commands that are executed to perform a sequence of settings without you or the host performing these commands through the GUI or text editor. It is similar to creating macros or solutions. After enabling the command logging, the batch file panel displays all commands as you click commands on the GUI. If the firmware contains batch files, the GUI will query the batch file names and list them in the Execute Batch Files group box. You can then choose a batch file from the list to execute it. See the DLP C900 Programmer's Guide for the batch file commands and Appendix B for a complete list of commands that can be used within a batch file. The Peripherals panel is used to operate all the external communications. The I2C group box allows external I2C devices to be controlled using one of the DLP C900 I2C interfaces. For example, if communicating with the LED driver through I2C, these values will depend on the module you are using. The Clock A configuration group box allows you to enable and control the output frequency of O'Clock A. The clock can be used as a source to some external logic. The GPIO configuration group box allows you to configure any of the 9 available input or output GPIOs. The Pulse Width Modulation Control Group box allows a user to configure any of the 4 available PWM outputs. Under the Firmware tab, you can update the firmware with patterns, batch files, and set startup conditions. To update the firmware on the EVM, click on the Choose Firmware button and use Firmware Image for the EVM type. Before clicking on the Download button, verify the EVM is powered up, operating normally, and connection has been established with the GUI. Within the app config settings, a user can select the default power-up state by checking the startup state checkbox and selecting the state from the drop-down list box. If the IT6535 digital receiver is present in the hardware, then a user may enable the use of this receiver by checking the HDMI/DP receiver checkbox. For more questions on operating the DLP LightCrafter 6500 or 9000, visit our ETE forum. Thanks for watching.